My friends, it is wonderful to share this moment of ministering to you as we are coming to you through live TV.
Det er fantastisk at være sammen med jer og dele det her øjeblik på live TV sammen med jer.
We are excited about the Word of God.
Vi er begejstrede over Guds ord.
We are excited about what God is doing, even in these moments of challenge.
Vi er begejstrede for hvad Gud gør også i de her tider af udfordringer.
Last Sunday we had our first drive-in service in our history.
I søndags havde vi vores første driving gudstjeneste nogensinde.
And Pastor Lena, tell us a little bit about how that was.
Og vi havde jo en fantastisk gudstjeneste, hvor folk kom kørende til i biler.
We had a fantastic service. People came from everywhere, of course by cars.
Mm-hmm. Vi havde jo været med os. Det var en fantastisk dag. Rigtig sommerdag næsten.
It was absolutely a beautiful day, nearly as a summer day.
Og Guds nærvær var fantastisk, lovsangen, forkyndelsen.
There was a strong presence of the Holy Spirit, there was worship, there was the ministering of the word.
Og vi så til og med nogle nye mennesker, som aldrig har været i KBC-kirken før.
And new people were there, which have never been in our church before.
Så det var en fantastisk oplevelse.
It was a great, great experience.
Og nu fortsætter vi jo næste søndag, det vil sige den 19. april.
And we will continue doing these drive-in services, so the next one will now be on this coming Sunday, the 19th.
Og det vil være klokken 14 om eftermiddagen.
And we will do it again at 2 o'clock in the afternoon.
Så kom og vær med.
So you are warmly welcome to attend.
Spred nyheden.
And share that with all your friends.
Vi har lagt ud på vores Facebook-side på kbc.dk.
And invite them to come and attend. We have also advertised at our Facebook KBC Facebook advertisement.
Ja. Og like og del.
And like and share as much as possible.
Fordi det er den måde vi spreder nyheden på.
If you go in and like and share, then it spreads through all the other connections you have.
Så lad os være en del af at kunne sprede evangeliet også på den her måde.
So let us share the gospel also in this manner and let us invite as many as possible.
Amen.
Now we had also something else which were a great experience in the Easter.
Og vi havde også en anden ting, som var meget spændende her i påsken.
We went in and we produced about 10 programs in Danish we called The Good News.
Og vi gik ind og producerede omkring 10 program, som på dansk hedder De Gode Nyheder.
Which also came out through the media platforms.
Som også kom ud igennem de forskellige medieplatformer.
Facebook and so on.
Facebook og så videre.
And there was a tremendous response.
Og der var fantastisk gensvar.
So we want to keep this momentum.
Så vi vil gerne bevare det her momentum.
And we want to extend these productions to produce programs which are targeting young people.
Og vi vil udvide den her produktion, så at vi også laver nogle produktioner, som målretter sig på unge mennesker for eksempel.
Families.
Familier.
Seniors.
Seniorer.
Business people.
Forretningsfolk.
So you will see us a lot more in different kind of shorter programs by where we will be relevant to the life of the Danish people.
Yeah. Så du vil se os i mange flere af de her kortere produktioner, hvor vi vil være relevante for de almindelige mennesker i Danmark.
And we are looking forward to even have many more KBC members being a part of these productions. So we will challenge you also to think about how you could reach your generation.
Og vi vil også gerne involvere mange flere af de almindelige kirkemedlemmer i KBC, så jeg vil også udfordre dig til at tænke, hvordan kan du nå dem som du er i kontakt med.
And as we are doing what we can to preach the gospel in these circumstances.
Og når vi nu gør hvad vi kan for at prædike evangeliet i de her omstændigheder.
We also experience that God is using this opportunity to touch people who has never been in church before.
Så oplever vi også at Gud tager den her mulighed og rører vi mennesker som ikke har fået muligheden før.
Now, when we're going to share the word of God tonight, I am going to start teaching you about unshakable faith.
Når vi nu skal starte undervisningen i aften, så skal vi begynde at tale om urokkelig tro.
But before we do that, I want to appreciate all of you who are KBC members and also standing with us in prayer and in faith.
Men jeg vil først bare værdsætte og sætte pris på alle jer, som er KBC-medlemmer og som står sammen med os i tro.
It's amazing to see the love and the response you have as you are also taking responsibility for us being a church.
Og det er vidunderligt at se jeres kærlighed og jeres omsorg, når I står sammen med os i at tage ansvar for kirken.
I understand why Paul with great joy said this statement to people who supported the preaching of the gospel.
Jeg forstår hvad Paulus sagde, når han lavede en udtale om dem som støttede i tjenesten.
He was so excited about them supporting the preaching of the word.
Han var så begejstret over dem som støttede ham i tjenesten og forkyndelsen af ordet.
And he said, "Then shall my God."
Så sagde han at så skal da min Gud.
According to his riches and glory in Christ Jesus.
I enlighed med hans rigdom og herlighed i Kristus Jesus.
Supply all your needs.
Fuldt ud giver jeg alt hvad I trænger
and
til.
That is also what I activate my faith for when it comes for you.
Og det er også det jeg aktiverer min tro for når det kommer til jer.
I am praying that God shall supply all your needs.
Jeg beder om at Gud skal give dig alt hvad du har brug for.
I pray that God will open doors for you.
At Gud vil åbne døre for dig.
That he will give you favor.
At han vil give dig favør.
And that you will not come out of this season as a loser.
Og at du ikke vil komme ud af den her sæson som en taber.
But you will come out as God becomes glorified through you.
Men du vil komme ud i, og Gud vil blive herliggjort igennem dig.
By him also supplying all your needs.
Også igennem at han forsørger dig og giver dig alt hvad du trænger til.
So I'm going to invite you also to release your tithe tonight.
Så jeg vil også invitere dig til at give din tiende i dag.
To sow your seed.
Til at så din sæd.
And release what the Holy Spirit speaks to you about.
Og forløse det, som Helligånden taler til dig om.
My favorite scripture when it comes to understanding how to give.
Mit favoritskriftsted, når det handler om at give.
It gives you clarity.
Det giver dig klarhed.
It says, each one of us shall give according to the purpose of our heart.
att den vär ska ge som hans hjärta har tillsagt han.
So you are not giving because there is a need.
Så du ger inte för att det är ett behov.
You are not giving because somebody manipulate you.
Du ger inte för att någon manipulerar dig.
You are not giving because you are emotionally touched.
Du ger inte för att du är känslomässigt berörd.
But you listen to the voice of the Holy Spirit.
Men du lyssnar till Helligandens stämma.
And as he speaks to you.
Och när han nu talar till dig.
Then you can give by faith.
Så kan du ge i tro.
And I would invite you to give as we are in this service tonight.
Och jag vill gärna invitera dig till att ge när vi nu är i den här gudstjänst i aften.
So Father God.
Så far Gud.
I pray for everyone who is now going to be participating this service, even ministering to you by giving.
Jag ber för var enkelt som tar del i och är med till att ge i löpet av den här gudstjänst idag.
And I thank you Father that you will bless them exceedingly and abundantly.
Jag tackar dig Gud för att du vill välsigna dem långt utöver vad vi ber om.
And Father, I release your blessing upon their life.
Och jag förlöser din välsignelse över deras liv.
Thank you that as we bring our love to you in this offering.
Tack att när vi nu bringer vår kärlek till dig i det här offer.
That you will receive it and you will multiply our seed.
Att du vill välsigna det eller ta emot det och du vill föröka vår säd.
And we give you all the honor for it.
Och vi ger dig all äran för det Gud.
So tonight there is opportunities to give also electronically.
Så i aften så är det också möjlighet för att ge elektroniskt.
And for those of you who are not from Denmark, you can go into KBC's website.
För dem av jer som inte är från Danmark så kan du ge eller gå in på vår hemsida.
KBC.dk.
KBC.dk.
And there is ways to give even also as the instructions are found there.
Och där finns alla de instruktioner du har brug för att kunna ge.
You can also give through PayPal.
Du kan också ge via PayPal.
And for us who are Danish citizens.
Och för oss som är danskar.
Mobile pay is the easiest way to give in a service like this.
Och har adgang till mobile pay så är det nämmaste måde att ge på den här måde.
And to use the mobile pay number it is
och för att bruka mobile pay nummer så är det
it is 777
så är det 777
and
461
461.
Mm-hmm.
So 777
777
461
461.
And I'm sure it'll come on the screen also.
Och jag är säker på att det också är på skärmen.
But you are so appreciated and welcome as you are standing with us also in this season.
Men vi sätter sån pris på dig och vi värdesätter att du står samman med oss i den här tid.
Can you give yourself a hug and say thank you for supporting the kingdom of God?
Ge dig selv et stort knus og bare sige tak for at du støtter Guds rige i den
God
her tid.
God will see your seed and he will also bless you as you are releasing it.
Gud han ser din sæd og han vil også velsigne dig når du sår den ind i Guds rige.
Isn't it amazing that Jesus saw the smallest coin this widow gave in the offering yeah. box?
Er det ikke vidunderligt at Jesus han så den der mindste mønt som enken gav i offerboxen.
So you do not give without God noticing it.
Så du giver ikke uden at Gud lægger mærke til det.
And he will multiply your seed.
Og han vil multiplicere din sæd, min ven.
But tonight we don't want to spend more time on inspiring you in giving.
Men i aften så vil vi ikke bruge mere tid til at inspirere dig til at give.
We want to jump straight into the word of God.
Vi vil hoppe direkte ind i Guds ord.
And if you go with me to Hebrew chapter 11.
Og hvis du går med mig til Hebræerbrevet kapitel 11.
I am still, as I said, going to talk to you about unshakable faith in a shakable time.
Og jeg skal tale til jer om urokkelig tro i en tid som ryster.
You see in Hebrews chapter 12.
I Hebræerbrevet kapitel 12.
There we know that the Bible says that once again everything will shake.
Der siger Bibelen at endnu en gang så vil jeg ryste alt det som rystes kan.
And when we are walking through these corona seasons.
Og når vi nu går igennem den her coronatid.
A lot of people they get paralyzed by fear.
Så der mange mennesker som bliver fuldstændig lammet af frygt.
A lot of people do not know what to believe or what to hope for.
Mange ved ikke hvad de skal tro eller håbe for.
And even questions comes up of what is the purpose of life.
Og spørgsmål om hvad livets betydning i virkeligheden er, kommer også.
A lot of things happens to us when we are challenged by circumstances.
Mange ting kommer op for os, når vi nu står i det her udfordrende situationer.
And therefore I want to show you what it is to live a lifestyle of faith.
Derfor vil jeg vise dig, hvad det betyder eller hvad det er at leve i en livsstil af tro.
And if you go and open the Bible now again to Hebrew chapter 11.
Og hvis du nu åbner Bibelen til Hebræerbrevet kapitel 11.
The English translation and the Danish translation has the same translation in its foundation.
Den engelske og danske oversættelse har grundlæggende den samme oversættelse.
But the English words are a little bit different than the Danes because of the English language.
Men de engelske oversættelser har lidt andre en anden formulering.
It is now in Hebrew 11 chapter 1 said now faith is the substance of things hoped for.
Og i Hebræerbrevet 11:1 så står der, nu troen er substansen af det, vi håber på.
So the English Bible is saying, now faith is the substance of things hoped for.
Så den engelske Bibel siger altså, at troen er substansen af det, vi håber på.
It is the evidence of things not seen.
Det er beviset på det, som vi ikke kan se.
So if you would ask, what is faith?
Så hvis du spørger, hvad er tro?
It is the evidence of things not seen.
Det er beviset på det, som vi ikke kan se.
How can you have an evidence if it is not visible?
Og hvordan kan du så have et bevis, hvis det ikke er synligt?
It is because the Bible says now faith is the substance.
Det er fordi Bibelen siger, at tro er substansen.
So you see, we all know what hope is.
Så vi ved alle, hvad håb er.
And hope is also a divine factor in our life.
Og håb er også noget guddommeligt i vores liv.
Hope is a powerful thing that propels us into the future.
Håbet er en meget stærk ting, som skubber os ind i vores fremtid.
We stretch for what we hope for.
Vi strækker os efter det, som vi håber efter.
But the difference
eller håber på.
Between hoping and believing.
Men forskellen mellem at håbe og tro.
It is that hope is always tomorrow.
Det er at håbet taler altid om i
morgen. But here in Hebrew 11:1 it says now faith is.
Men på engelsk står det her i Hebræerbrevet 11:1 at nu er troen.
Now faith is.
Nu er troen.
Hope is not now.
Tro eller håb er ikke nu.
Hope is tomorrow.
Håb er i morgen.
But here the English translation says now faith is.
Men her siger den engelske oversættelse at nu er tro.
So what is the difference of hope and faith?
Så hvad er forskellen mellem håb og tro?
The beauty of hope.
Det smukke ved håb
is that you have not lost hope that it can happen.
Det er, du har ikke mistet håbet om at det virkelig kan ske.
Can you remember Abraham?
Kan du huske Abraham?
Look together with me for a moment in Romans chapter 4.
Kig sammen med mig i Romerbrevet kapitel 4.
And there is a statement of Abraham's faith.
Og her udtales det om Abrahams tro.
And the Bible says about the way Abraham believed God.
Og her siger Bibelen eller taler Bibelen om hvordan Abraham troede på Gud.
We can go in and read in verse 17.
Og vi kan læse fra vers 17.
As it is written, I have made you a father of many nations.
Sådan som det står skrevet, jeg gør dig til fader til mange folkeslag.
In the presence of him who believe even God who gives life to the dead and call those things which are not existing as they did.
Fader over for Gud, som han troede på. Gud, som gør de døde levende og kalder på det, der ikke er til, så det bliver til.
And then listen carefully to verse 18.
Og så lyt opmærksom på vers 18.
The English Bible translated like this.
Den engelske siger på den her måde.
And I like the Danish and especially the Swedish translation very much.
Og jeg kan lide den danske, men især den svenske rigtig meget.
But let me read the English one. Who in contrary to hope, in hope believed, so he became father of many nations, conducting to what was spoken.
Med håb, imod håb, troede han, og at han skulle blive fader til en mængde folkeslag, som det var sagt ham. Så mange skal dine efterkommere blive.
The English Bible puts it in this manner and the Danish in another manner. But let me quote the Swedish translation for you.
Den danske siger det på et sæt, og den engelske på en anden, men lad mig citere den svenske for dig.
Because the Swedish really brings it out in a powerful way.
For den svenske bringer det frem på en meget stærk måde.
It says now, where there were no hope, he hoped indeed.
Der hvor intet håb fandtes, håbede han alligevel.
And believed.
Og troede.
And it was counted him to righteousness.
Og det blev regnet ham til retfærdighed.
So he had a hopeless situation.
Så han havde en håbløs situation.
Where there was no hope, that means it's hopeless.
Der var ingen håb. Det vil sige, det var håbløst.
There was nothing to hope for.
Der var ingenting at håbe for.
When do you come to a place where things are hopeless?
Hvornår kommer du til det sted, hvor tingene er håbløse?
That happens when you cannot see any way out of it.
Det sker, når du ikke kan se din vej ud af det.
Hope is still seeing an option.
Håbet ser altid en mulighed.
Hope still expects something good to happen.
Håbet forventer noget godt, at noget godt sker.
But if you are hopeless,
men hvis du er håbløs,
if there is no hope,
hvis du ikke har noget håb,
then all the options are gone.
Så er ligesom alle mulighederne væk.
And in Abraham's case, that was how it was.
Og i Abrahams tilfælde, så var det sådan, det var.
His wife could not have children.
Hans kone kunne ikke få nogen børn.
He was old.
Han var gammel.
So looking at the natural circumstances, there was nothing to hope for.
Så når vi kiggede på de naturlige omstændigheder, så var der ikke noget at håbe for.
The challenging thing about God.
Men det udfordrende med Gud.
Is that he can say things that cannot happen for us as people in our ability.
Det er, at han kan se ting, som ikke kan ske for os, fordi vi og vores naturlige omstændigheder ikke kan se det.
And that's why I want to teach you tonight about faith.
Og derfor vil jeg gerne undervise dig om tro i aften.
Because if you don't know the capacity of the God kind of faith that is in you.
Fordi hvis du ikke kender den kapacitet, som Guds slags tro har i dig,
then you will give up before you should give up.
Så giver du op, før du skulle give op.
You will then resign before you get over the finishing line.
Så vil du træde tilbage, før du afslutter og løber over hvad hedder det, mållinjen.
What did Abraham do?
Hvad var det, Abraham
gjorde? Listen carefully.
Lidt opmærksom.
Verse 19 says.
Vers 19 siger.
And not being weak in faith.
Uden at blive svag i troen.
He considered his own body already dead since he was about 100 years old, and Sarah's womb was also dead.
At hans krop allerede var uden livskraft. Han var næsten 100 år gammel, og Saras moderliv var dødt.
So he has these circumstances.
Så han havde de her omstændigheder.
Hopeless.
Håbløse.
But what did verse 18 say?
Men hvad sagde vers 18 her?
Where there were no hope, he hoped indeed.
Der hvor der intet håb fandtes, der håbede han alligevel.
And believed.
Og troede.
You see, your capacity of faith does not start by faith.
Du forstår, din kapacitet i tro starter ikke i troen.
It starts by hope.
Det starter i håbet.
Hope moves you in the direction of your miracle.
Håbet bevæger dig i retning af dit mirakel.
Hope gives you the inspiration to stretch for it.
Håbet giver dig inspirationen til at strække sig efter det.
My beloved friend, no matter how hopeless your circumstances is even tonight.
Min ven, lige meget hvor håbløs dine omstændigheder ser ud også i aften.
No matter how difficult your circumstances are for you.
Lige meget hvor svære dine omstændigheder ser ud i.
The Bible still says that all things are possible for he who believes.
Så siger Bibelen stadigvæk, at alle ting er mulige for den som tror.
You say, but I don't want to hear one more message about that.
Ja, men så siger du, jeg vil ikke høre et budskab mere om det.
I just gave up on faith.
Jeg har bare opgivet troen.
Because it doesn't seem to work.
Det virker ikke som om, at det virker i det hele taget.
Now, sometimes people think they are in faith, but they were not. They were more in hope.
Og nogle gange så tror mennesker faktisk, at de er i tro, men i virkeligheden så er de bare i håbet.
Now, that is not spoken by me to speak down to you.
Og det er jo ikke udtalt eller sagt for at tale ned til dig.
No, I'm not speaking down to you at all.
Nej, jeg taler slet ikke ned til dig.
I'm just trying to show you the difference of these two moments.
Men jeg prøver bare at vise dig forskellen i de her to øjeblikke.
Remember that there are three things that are eternal.
Husk, at der er tre ting, der er evige.
Faith, hope and love.
Der er tro, håb och kärlighet.
They are eternal.
De är eviga.
And greatest of these are love.
Och största av dem alla tre är kärligheten.
So hope is going to work even in heaven.
Så håpet kommer också till att virka i himlen.
Faith will operate even in heaven.
Tro kommer också till att virka i himlen.
And of course you would agree with me that love would operate.
Och naturligtvis kärligheten kommer också till att virka.
So you are not a mistake just because you are at the process of hope.
Så du är ju inte en fejltagelse eller är på fel väg bara för att du är i hopets process.
You didn't lose your victory just because you are in hope.
Du har inte mistat din seger bara för att du är i hopet.
No, by being in hope you are on your way to your breakthrough.
Nej, vid att vara i hopet så är du på väg till ditt genombrott.
It's a beautiful thing to have the power of hope.
Det är en vidunderlig ting att ha kraften i hoppet.
But what do you do when you move from hope to faith?
Men vad gör du i det ögonblick du beveger dig från hopp och över i tron?
Hope is, as I said, tomorrow.
Hoppet är alltid imorgon.
But faith is now.
Men tro är nu.
So where there was no hope, in other words, it was hopeless.
Så där var inte hopp fantes, det vill säga det var hopplöst.
He indeed hoped.
Där hoppade han alligevel.
So the divine capacity of hope is stronger than the hopeless.
Så hoppets gudomliga kapacitet är starkare än det hopplösa.
Now it can be hopeless if you have no options.
Det kan ju vara hopplöst hvis du inte har någon naturliga möjligheter.
But God's life in you creating hope.
Men Guds liv i dig skapar hopp.
And that hope overcomes the hopeless.
Och det hopp övervinner det hopplösheten.
For some unexplainable reason you hope when there is nothing to hope for.
Af en eller anden uforklarlig årsag så håber du selvom det ser håbløst ud.
Maybe it's not that unexplainable.
Måske er det ikke så uforklarligt.
Because God spoke to you.
Fordi Gud talte til dig.
And that word created faith in your inward man.
Og det ord som Gud talte skabte en tro i dit indre.
And the Bible says that faith cometh by hearing.
Og det står at tro kommer af det der høres.
And hearing by the word of God.
Og det der høres kommer i kraft af Kristi ord.
So when you hear God's will.
Så når du hører Guds vilje.
That word will start by creating hope in you.
Så vil det ord starte og begynde med at skabe håb i dig.
And it's very interesting that in Hebrews chapter 10.
Og det er meget interessant i Hebræerbrevet kapitel 10.
I can show you a scripture saying, hold on to your confession of hope.
Så står der, og jeg kan vise dig skriftstedet, hvor der står at hold fast ved håbets bekendelse.
Hebrews chapter 10.
Hebræerbrevet kapitel 10.
Hold on to your confession of hope.
Hold fast ved håbets bekendelse.
Did you notice it didn't say hold on to your confession of faith?
Lad du mærke til at det ikke stod hold fast ved troens bekendelse.
Maybe Pastor Lino, we should just go there quickly.
Måske skal vi bare hurtigt gå dertil.
So you can see that it's not something I come up with.
Så du kan se at det ikke bare noget som jeg finder på.
And it says if I can find it here.
Og det står hvis jeg kan finde det her.
We can see that in 23. Verse 23.
I vers 23.
Let's hold on to the confession of our hope without wavering, for he who promised is faithful.
Hebræerbrevet 10:23. Lad os holde urokkeligt fast ved bekendelsen af vort håb, for han som gav os løftet er trofast.
So when you start operating in hope.
Så når du begynder at virke og fungere i håbet.
That hope activates your faith.
Så aktiverer det håb din tro.
And the Bible says you should hold on to the confession of your hope.
Og Bibelen siger at du skal holde fast ved bekendelsen af det håb.
Because faithful is he who gave the promise.
Fordi trofast er han som gav løftet.
Now why does it start out as confessing hope?
Hvorfor begynder det med at bekende sin håb?
Because when you start speaking to yourself.
Fordi når du begynder at tale til dig selv.
Hope opens up for the capacity of faith.
Så åbner håbet op for troens kapacitet.
Remember that the Bible says that faith cometh by hearing, and hearing by the word of God.
Husk at Bibelen siger at troen kommer af det der høres, og det der høres kommer i kraft af Kristi ord.
So when you confess and declare the word of God by hope.
Så når du begynder at proklamere Guds ord igennem håbet.
It is not that you have it in this moment you say it.
Så er du ikke fordi at du har det i det øjeblik du siger det.
But you are speaking about what you hope.
Men du taler om det du håber.
You are confessing and declaring your hope.
Du bekender og proklamerer det du håber.
What happens as you do that?
Hvad sker der når du så gør det?
Faith comes by hearing.
Så kommer troen der af det der høres.
And suddenly as you continue declaring your hope.
Og lige pludselig imens du fortsætter med håbets bekendelse.
It will slide into your heart.
Så kommer det ind i dit hjerte.
And you move yourself from hoping to believing.
Så bevæger du dig selv fra håbet og over i troen.
And let's go back now to Romans.
Og lad os så gå tilbage til Romerbrevet her.
Where it was hopeless.
Hvor det var håbløst.
He hoped indeed and believed.
Der håbede han endda og troede.
And the amazing statement, Pastor Lena, is here in verse 19, that not being weak in faith.
Og der står det utrolige her i pastor i vers 19, uden at være svag i troen.
So you see, his faith became strong.
Så det vil sige, at hans tro blev stærk.
It is still hopeless.
Det er stadig håbløst.
If you should ask yourself, can it happen?
Hvis du skulle spørge dig selv, kan det ske?
For him declaring the promise didn't change his wife.
Jeg mener, det at han proklamerede løftet forandrede ikke hans hustru.
She didn't become 20 years younger just because he said, I am going to have a son.
Hun blev ikke 20 år yngre bare fordi han sagde, at jeg skal have en søn.
No, she was still this oldest person.
Nej, hun var stadigvæk den her ældre person.
I mean, I don't know if you can take my humor.
Jeg ved ikke om du kan klare min humor.
But it took faith even for her to kiss him.
Men det krævede endda tro til for hende at bare kysse ham.
Oh my goodness.
Du godeste.
He didn't look too romantic himself.
Han så heller ikke selv for romantisk ud.
But you see, faith is not about emotions.
Men du forstår, tro handler ikke om følelser.
Faith is about a promise.
Tro handler om et løfte.
And I'm just giving you a short understanding of how to know what faith is.
Og jeg giver dig bare en kort forståelse af at vide, hvordan tro er.
So don't feel miserable because you're not in faith.
Så lad være med at være elendig bare over at du ikke ved hvor, eller er kommet til troen.
It is, hvad hedder nederlag?
It is defeat.
It is not a defeat that you are not in faith.
Det er ikke et nederlag at du ikke er i tro.
No, if you are in hope, you are on the victorious way.
Nej, om du er i håbet, så er du på den sejrende vej.
Hold on to your confession of hope.
Hold fast i håbets bekendelse.
Keep speaking it.
Bliv ved med at tale det ud.
Keep declaring it.
Bliv ved med at proklamere det.
Why?
Hvorfor?
Faith cometh by hearing.
Fordi tro kommer af det der høres.
If you don't speak it, you won't believe it.
Hvis du ikke taler det ud, så vil du ikke tro på det.
If you don't hear yourself saying it, you will never believe it.
Hvis du ikke hører dig selv sige det, så vil du aldrig tro på det.
Didn't Jesus himself says, whosoever says to this mountain.
Sagde ikke Jesus selv, at hvem som helst som tror eller siger til dette bjerg.
So it all starts by speaking.
Så det begynder alt sammen med at tale.
But it is not necessarily the confession or declaration of faith.
Men det er ikke nødvendigvis en udtalelse af tro lige nu.
It starts by declaring hope.
Men det begynder med at proklamere håbet.
Why is that so important?
Hvorfor er det så vigtigt?
So you don't lose courage.
Så du ikke mister modet.
Because you know you are moving into faith.
For du ved at du bevæger dig ind i troen.
So even if it still looks impossible.
Så selvom det stadig ser umuligt ud.
Or hopeless.
Eller håbløst.
You are moving beyond the hopeless.
Så bevæger du dig ud over det håbløse.
That's why the Bible says that the hope is an anchor.
Det er derfor, at Bibelen siger, at håbet er et anker.
And that anchor is behind the veil in the heavenly temple.
Og det anker er bag ved det himmelske forhæng i templet.
What do you do with an anchor?
Hvad gør du med et anker?
You pull yourself in.
Du trækker dig selv ind.
Where is your anchor of hope?
Hvor er håbets anker?
In the heavenly temple.
I det himmelske tempel.
Behind the veil.
Bag ved forhænget.
That means where Jesus is sitting at the right side of the Father.
Det betyder det er der hvor Jesus sidder på faderens højre hånd.
So hope pulls you out of the hopeless.
Så håbet trækker dig ud af det håbløse situation.
Did you get it, my friend?
Fik du fat i det, min ven?
Hope pulls you out of the hopeless.
Håbet trækker dig ud af håbløsheden.
And as you're confessing your hope.
Og når du nu bekender dit håb.
You are pulled out of the hopeless into your glorious hope.
Så trækker du dig ud af det håbløse og ind i dit herlige håb.
The hope of what he said.
Håbet om det han sagde.
All the promises have received its yes and amen in Christ.
Alle Guds løfter har fået sit ja og amen i Kristus.
And as you by hope declare what he says.
Og når du nu i håbet proklamerer det han siger.
You pull yourself into his presence.
Så trækker du dig selv ind i hans nærvær.
The Bible says that faith is coming.
Bibelen siger selv at troen kommer.
If you don't have faith.
Hvis ikke du har tro.
My friend, faith can come.
Min ven, troen kan komme.
Don't ever say I cannot believe that.
Se aldrig til dig selv det kan jeg ikke tro.
Oh,
på.
I give up on this.
Oh, det giver jeg op på.
This, you know, is out of my league.
Det her det er bare uden for min liga.
It's too big for me.
Det er alt for stort for mig.
Of course it's too big for you.
Selvfølgelig er det for stort for dig.
Of course it's out of your league.
Selvfølgelig er det uden for din liga.
Because it is not you who's going to perform the miracle.
For det er ikke dig der skal udføre miraklet.
It is God who is the miracle working God.
Det er Gud som er med det mirakelgørende Gud.
If you didn't know, I believe in miracles.
Hvis du ikke vidste det, så tror jeg på mirakler.
I said, in case you don't know, I believe in miracles.
Hvis du ikke ved det, så tror jeg på mirakler.
But not miracles in itself, but the miracle working God.
Men ikke miraklerne i sig selv, men på det mirakelgørende Guden.
Mary, she heard something and it was hopeless for her.
Maria, hun hørte noget, og det var fuldstændig håbløst for hende.
She couldn't even figure out, I don't know a man, this is impossible.
Hun kunne ikke engang finde ud af det. Hun sagde, jeg kender ikke nogen mand, det er umuligt det her.
Then the angel says, with God all things are possible.
Og så sagde englen på engelsk, med Gud er alt muligt.
The Danish translation say, for God all things are possible.
Den danske oversættelse siger, for Gud er alting muligt.
But in the English Bible it says, with God all things are possible.
Men den engelske oversættelse siger, at med Gud, sammen med Gud, er alting muligt.
How can it be with God?
Hvordan kan det være sammen
Because
med Gud?
Because your faith is anchored in his throne room.
Fordi troen er forankret i tronrummet.
You are placed with Jesus Christ in the heavenly place.
Du er placeret med Jesus Kristus i det himmelske.
So your faith has the capacity to receive what you hope for.
Så din tro har kapaciteten at tage imod det, som du håbede for.
Keep speaking what God said to you.
Bliv ved med at tale det ud, som Gud har talt til dig om.
Keep speaking his promises.
Bliv ved med at tale ud hans løfter.
Keep confessing and declaring.
Bliv ved med at bekende og proklamere.
Greater is he that is in me than he who is in the world.
Som er i mig, end den, som er i verden.
I am blessed by all heavenly spiritual blessings.
Jeg er velsignet med alle den himmelske verdens åndelige velsignelser.
In Christ Jesus I have all wisdom and all knowledge.
I Kristus Jesus har jeg al visdom og al kundskab.
All the gift of the Spirit is given to me by the grace of God through the Holy Spirit.
Alle åndens gaver er givet til mig igennem Helligåndens nåde.
When I lay hands on the sick they shall recover.
Når jeg lægger hænderne på de syge så skal de blive raske.
I have been given authority over all devils and power to heal all diseases.
Jeg er blevet givet magtoritet og magt over alle dæmoner og kan helbrede alle sygdomme.
I have been given a power and authority to loose and to bind.
Jeg har magt og autoritet til at løse og til at binde.
The Bible says that I am in Christ the head and not the tail.
Bibelen siger at i Kristus er jeg hoved og ikke hale.
The Bible says I shall not borrow but I shall lend out to many people.
Bibelen siger jeg skal ikke låne men jeg skal låne ud til mange mennesker.
My Bible says when I have been giving there shall be given to me.
Min Bibel siger at når jeg har givet så skal der gives til mig.
I have brought my tithe and therefore the gates of heaven is open upon me.
Jeg har givet min tiende, derfor er himlens vinduer åbne over mig.
The Bible says that everything I do and everything I touch will prosper.
Bibelen siger at alt det jeg gør, alt det jeg rører ved skal lykkes.
The Bible says that the word of God will work mightily in me and perform what it was sent for.
Bibelen siger at Guds ord skal virke mægtigt i mig og udføre det er sendt for at gøre.
I can confess now a whole hour.
Og jeg kan blive ved med at bekende en hel time.
What happens when I speak the word to myself?
Hvad er det der sker når jeg begynder at tale ordet til mig selv?
I hold on to my confession of hope.
Jeg holder fast ved håbets bekendelse.
But because it's not just something I do each 10 years.
Men fordi at det ikke bare er noget jeg gør hver 10 år.
Because I confess and declare the word over my life every day.
Fordi at jeg bekender ordet over mit liv hver eneste dag.
This grace takes me from hope into faith.
Derfor tager den her nåde mig fra håbet og ind i troen.
And faith becomes strong.
Og troen bliver stærk.
Did you see that in Abraham's life?
Så du det i Abrahams liv?
And not being weak in faith, he considered his own body already dead.
Og ikke være svag i troen, selvom han betragtede sit eget legeme som værende dødt.
My Danish translation says he got strengthened in his faith.
Og min danske bibel siger, at han blev styrket i troen.
How can you be strengthened in faith when it is still in your circumstances hopeless?
Og hvordan kan du blive styrket i troen, når dine omstændigheder stadigvæk ser om håbløse ud?
It's because faith is a divine ability.
Det er fordi håbet er troen er en guddommelig evne.
To see the impossible.
At se det umulige.
Open the Bible and look together with me as we are looking in. Let us see if I can take you to 2 Corinthians chapter 5.
Lad os gå til 2 Korintherbrev kapitel 5.
And this is also familiar to many of you.
Og det er også meget bekendt for nogle af jer.
But let me read it for you.
Men lad mig læse det for dig.
For we walk by faith and not by sight.
5 vers 7. For vi lever i tro, ikke i det, som kan ses.
Look at 2 Corinthians chapter 4, verse 18.
Lad os kigge i kapitel 4, vers 18.
While we do not look at the things which are seen, but at the things which are not seen, for the things which are seen are only temporary, but the things which are not seen are eternal.
For vi ser ikke på det synlige, men på det usynlige. Det synlige varer jo kun en tid. Det usynlige varer evigt.
So what does faith do for you?
Så hvad er det troen gør for dig?
Faith gives you ability to see you having what God promised.
Troen giver dig evnen til at se, at du kan have det, som Bibelen har lovet. At du har det, som er lovet.
It gives you the ability.
Det giver dig evnen.
To see yourself having what he said.
Til at se dig selv have det, som det bliver sagt.
Now hope see yourself on your way to having it.
Håbet ser dig på vej til at få
but
det.
But faith see yourself having it.
Men troen ser at du allerede har det.
You say, but how can I believe I have something I don't see?
Men hvordan kan jeg så tro på noget, som jeg ikke allerede kan se?
What did the Bible say?
Hvad sagde Bibelen?
While we do not look at things which are seen.
For vi ser ikke på det som kan ses.
But the things which are not seen.
Men på det usynlige.
For the things which are seen are only temporary.
For det som er synligt varer jo kun en kort tid.
If you're listening carefully now.
Hvis du lytter opmærksomt.
Let me give you a thought.
Lad mig give dig en tanke.
God says here to you.
Gud siger her til dig.
That everything which is visible in this world.
Er alt det som er synligt i den her verden.
Is only temporary.
Er kun for en tid.
So if you have a disease.
Så hvis du har en sygdom.
Is that gonna stick to you the rest of your life?
Kommer det så til at vare resten af dit liv?
Absolutely not.
Så helt sikkert ikke.
Because everything which is visible is temporary.
For alt det synlige er kun for en tid.
If you are challenged by finances.
Hvis du udfordret af økonomien.
Are you then gonna stick to poverty the rest of your life?
Skal du så forblive fattig resten af dit liv?
No, that is not God's will for you.
Nej, det er ikke Guds vilje for
because
dig.
Because maybe you have a season of famine.
Måske har du en sæson af hungersnød.
But let me prophesy to you.
Men lad mig profetere for
that
dig.
That season is temporary.
At den sæson er for en
you're
tid.
You're coming out of lack.
Du kommer ud af mangel.
You're coming out of having
du
not enough.
Du kommer ud af at ikke have nok.
And that's the amazing thing about faith.
Og det er det utrolige ved troen.
While we do not look at the things which are.
Imens vi ikke kigger på det som er.
So Abraham could still see him and his wife could not have babies.
Det vil sige Abraham kunne stadigvæk se på at han selv og Sara ikke kunne få
but
børn.
But hope took him over the challenge.
Men håbet tog ham ud over for, udfordringen.
And by faith he saw himself being a father.
Og i troen så han sig selv blive far.
He saw his wife pregnant.
Han så sin kone gravid.
How do you know that, Pastor Jens?
Hvordan ved du det, Pastor Jens?
Very simple.
Meget enkelt.
When God by covenant changed his and Sarah's name.
Når Gud ved pakten forandrede hans og Saras navn.
Before they gave birth to Isaac.
Før de fødte af Isaac.
They said to one another.
Så sagde de til hinanden.
Father of many nations.
Fader af mange nationer.
Every time Sarah called her husband.
Hver eneste gang Sarah kaldte på sin mand.
She said the impossible.
Så sagde hun det umulige.
How can you be so silly?
Hvordan kan du være så dum?
To declare something that is impossible.
At proklamere noget og sige noget som er umuligt.
You see, for doubters, faith is a provocation.
Fordi for tvivlerne så er troen en provokation.
For doubters, faith even reveals their doubt.
For dem som tvivler, så afslører troen deres tvivl.
Have you ever asked yourself why they wanted to kill Jesus in Nazareth?
Har du nogensinde spurgt dig selv hvorfor Nazareth gerne ville slå Jesus ihjel?
Remember they wanted to throw him over the cliff.
Husk at de ville kaste ham ud over klippen.
How in the whole world could they have that idea?
Og hvordan i hele verden kunne de få den idé?
Because an hour before.
Fordi en time før.
He was reading from the scrolls of Isaiah.
Så læste han fra bogrullen fra Isaias bog.
And he says the spirit of the Lord is upon me.
Og han siger Herrens ånd er over mig.
He has anointed me to preach the good news.
Han har salvet mig til at forkynde de gode nyheder.
Preach the good news to the poor.
At forkynde de gode nyheder for de fattige.
Sign for the blind and captivity for the captives.
Syn for de blinde og freedom from the captive. Ja. Yeah. Frihed fra de fangne.
And a year of jubilee.
Og et jubelår fra Herren.
So when you hear him.
Så når du hører ham.
You hear him preaching under the anointing of the Almighty God.
Og så hører du ham forkynde under Helligåndens den almægtige Guds salvelse.
He is preaching until they say to themselves.
Og han prædiker og forkynder indtil de siger ved sig selv.
We have never heard life-giving words like this.
Vi har aldrig hørt livgivende ord som dem her.
They praise his teaching.
De priser hans undervisning.
Until one moment.
Indtil et øjeblik.
And that is when he says.
Og det er når han siger.
Today.
I dag.
It is fulfilled.
Er dette skriftord går i opfyldelse.
How does it come that they are now suddenly so angry that they want to kill him?
Hvordan kan det være at de så lige pludselig er så vrede så de vil slå ham ihjel?
Because faith will release doubt.
Fordi tro
will reveal doubt.
Vil afsløre tvivlen.
Faith.
Tro.
Will reveal doubt.
Vi afslører tvivlen.
They all agreed that this is beautiful one day.
De alle var enige om at det her var vidunderligt en eller anden dag.
They were all in the dimension of hope.
De var alle sammen i håbets dimension.
That one day Messiah would come and declare this for us.
At en dag så vil Messias komme og proklamere det her for os.
But what changed the whole scenery?
Men hvad var det som forandrede hele sceneriet?
It was the faith of one man.
Det var troen hos en mand.
The man Jesus they knew very well.
Manden Jesus som de kendte rigtig godt.
He said today.
Han sagde i dag.
This scripture is fulfilled.
Skal dette skriftsted opfyldes?
Why do you think they wanted to kill him?
Hvorfor tror du de gerne vil slå ham ihjel?
Because they just said what life-giving words.
Fordi de har jo lige sagt til ham, åh, hvilke livsalige ord.
It's because when he brought it into now.
Det er fordi når han nu bragte det ind i nutid.
They had to make a stand.
Så var de nødt til at tage stilling.
Either to believe with him.
Enten til at tro sammen med ham.
Or come against it.
Eller komme imod det.
That's the conflict of the capacity of faith.
Og det er konflikten som findes i troens kapacitet.
When somebody says we can do it.
Når nogen siger vi kan gøre det.
It will force somebody else to say it's impossible.
Så vil det tvinge nogen anden til at sige nej, det er umuligt.
Remember Israel and the 12 or 10 scouts?
Husk Israel og de 12 spejder.
10 of them they had one report.
10 af dem havde en rapport.
But two of them had a different spirit, Joshua and Caleb.
Men to af dem havde en anden ånd, Joshua og Caleb.
And they said, Joshua and Caleb.
Og de sagde, Joshua og Caleb.
For surely we can take the land.
Sandelig, vi kan tage landet.
Why did they Why did they say that?
Hvorfor sagde de det på
they
den måde?
They saw the same land.
For de så samme land.
The same capacity.
Samme kapacitet.
But they saw it through faith.
Men de så det igennem troens øjne.
The 10 of them who got paralyzed and got the grasshopper disease.
De 10 af dem som blev lammet og fik den her græshoppesyndrom.
Being smaller than small.
At være mindre end mindst.
Then in their own eyes.
I deres egne øjne.
We felt like grasshoppers.
Vi følte os som græshopper.
How can anybody in a covenant with God say I feel like a grasshopper?
Hvordan kan nogen som står i pagt med Gud selv føle sig som en græshopper?
That is mocking God's covenant.
Det er jo at håne Guds pagt.
Maybe you feel you are nothing, but in Christ you are everything.
Måske føler du at du er ingenting, men i Kristus er du alt.
So don't speak about yourself, speak about him.
Så tal ikke om dig selv, tal om ham.
So they saw the same wonderful land.
Så de så det samme vidunderlige land.
But their faith revealed the other's doubt.
Men deres tvivl deres tro afslørede de andres tvivl.
I want to teach you something.
Jeg vil gerne lære dig noget her.
You are going to live in the conflict zone the moment you start living the lifestyle of faith.
Du kommer til at leve i en konfliktzone i det øjeblik du begynder at leve i en livsstil af tro.
Because you're eager to see God's promises fulfilled will provoke everybody else to speak against it.
For din iver efter at se Guds løfter gå i opfyldelse vil provokere alle andre som ikke kan se det gå i opfyldelse.
Get used to that conflict.
Bliv vant til den konflikt, min ven.
Because you cannot explain faith.
For du kan ikke forklare tro.
It is supernatural.
Det er overnaturligt.
It's divine.
Det er guddommeligt.
It is God's faith in you.
Det er Guds tro i dig.
How do you believe that you have faith?
Hvordan tror du? Du har tro.
How do you explain that you have it?
Hvordan forklarer du, at du har det?
We can see many things.
Vi kan se mange ting.
But you know when you don't have it.
Men du ved når du ikke har det.
And you know when you have it.
Og du ved hvornår du har det.
It is not easy to explain what it is.
Det er ikke nemt at forklare hvad det er.
It's like love.
Det er som kærlighed.
How do you explain that you love somebody?
Hvordan kan du forklare at du elsker nogen?
Oh yeah, you can say that you are pleased with their personality.
Ja, men du kan sige, ja, men jeg synes godt om deres personlighed.
I like, you know, the way they handle me.
Jeg kan godt lide den måde som de er sammen med mig på.
I am impressed about their charm.
Jeg er imponeret over deres charme.
Many things which we can define love as.
Mange ting som vi kan definere kærlighed som.
But the honest truth is.
Men den ærlige sandhed er.
That there is really not words that can say what it is in its core.
Men at der i virkeligheden ikke er ord som kan ligesom forklare hvad det er i sin kerne.
But you know when you love somebody.
Men du ved når du elsker nogen.
Even if you don't have the words for it.
Selvom du ikke kan udtrykke det i ord.
It is so real.
Det er så virkeligt.
The same with faith.
Det samme med tro.
We can look at all the scriptures.
Vi kan kigge på alle skriftstederne.
You will know if you don't have it.
Du vil vide hvis du ikke har det.
Because then your mouth will speak doubt.
For så begynder din mund at tale tvivl.
What your heart is full of, your mouth will speak.
Det dit hjerte er fyldt af, det kommer din mund til at tale.
So that's why they were so angry.
Det er derfor de var så vrede.
In Nazareth that day.
I Nazaret den dag.
Because their doubt was revealed.
For deres tvivl blev afsløret.
I have seen that in my own life.
Jeg har set det i mit eget liv.
When I came to Denmark more than 20 or Copenhagen more than 30 years ago.
Når jeg kom til København for mere end 30 år siden.
And I started to declare that we are going to see a breakthrough for the kingdom of God.
Og jeg begyndte at proklamere, vi skal se et gennembrud for Guds rige.
I don't know why the body of Christ had the ability to give me a feeling that they hated me.
Jeg ved ikke hvorfor det havde en evne til at
Kristi krop
havde en evne til at få mig til at føle at de havde mig.
I don't know why they had to speak against me like that.
Jeg ved ikke hvorfor de var nødt til at tale imod mig på den måde.
Oh, you must have said something that upset them.
Jamen, du måde har sagt noget som ligesom gjorde dem oprørte.
Jesus also said something that upset them in Nazareth.
Jesus sagde også noget som gjorde dem oprevet i Nazareth.
It is the moment you say today.
Det er det øjeblik du siger i dag.
What did Hebrew 11 say about faith?
Hvad sagde Hebræerbrevet 11 om tro?
Now faith is.
Nu er troen.
So when Abraham back to him.
Så Abraham tilbage til ham.
Had a hopeless situation.
Havde en håbløs situation.
Where there were no hope, he hoped indeed and believed.
Der hvor intet håb fandtes, der håbede han alligevel og troede.
What did the faith do for him?
Hvad gjorde troen for ham?
As Romans chapter 4 as 2 Corinthians chapter 4 says.
Som 2 Korinther 4 siger.
We do not walk we walk by faith and not by sight.
At vi vandrer i tro og ikke i det vi ser.
And as we are not looking at the things which are but the things which are not seen.
For vi ser ikke på det synlige, men på det usynlige.
What did faith do for Abraham in the hopeless situation?
Hvad gjorde troen for Abraham i den håbløse situation?
He saw beyond the impossible.
Han så ud over den umulige situation.
He saw himself being a father.
Han så sig selv blive far.
And it was counted him to righteousness.
Og det blev regnet ham til retfærdighed.
Verse 20 is very powerful.
Vers 20 er meget stærk.
He did not waver in the promise of God through unbelief, but he was strengthened in faith, giving God glory.
Og vi er tilbage i Romerbrevet 4, vers 20. Og han tvivlede ikke i vantro på Guds løfte, men han blev tværtimod styrket i troen og gav Gud æren.
Are you ready to listen to
this
now?
Er du klar til at lytte til det her?
And being fully convinced,
og fuldt overbevist,
that he who had promised also are able to perform.
At han har lovet, fuldt overbevist om at det som Gud har lovet, har han også magt til at gøre.
Isn't it amazing?
Er det ikke fantastisk?
It is still hopeless.
Det er stadig håbløst.
The child is not even, you know, conceived.
Barnet er ikke engang undfanget.
He is looking at this old lady.
Han kigger på den her gamle dame.
I don't know what she saw in that old man.
Jeg ved ikke hvad hun så i den gamle mand.
But faith can do amazing things.
Men tro kan gøre fantastiske ting.
So they believe that he who has promised has power to perform. De troede at ham der havde lovet, det havde magten til at gøre det. Amen. So faith is an amazing capacity.
Så troen er en helt fantastisk kapacitet.
To receive the impossible.
Til at tage imod det umulige.
How can faith receive the impossible?
Hvordan kan tro tage imod det umulige?
Because God is the God of miracles.
Fordi Gud er miraklernes Gud.
He makes able what nobody can do.
Han evner at gøre det som ingen anden kan.
And if he has said it,
og hvis han har sagt det,
there is power in that word to perform it.
Så er der kraft i det ord til at udføre det.
I want to encourage you, my friend.
Jeg vil gerne opmuntre dig, min ven.
You have so many words spoken over your life.
Du har så mange ord, som er udtalt over dit liv.
You have received prophecies.
Du har modtaget profetier.
You have promises as you have been reading it in the Bible.
Du har løfter, når du har læst i Guds ord.
I challenge you.
Jeg vil gerne udfordre dig.
Not to camp in the season of hope.
Ikke bare forblive og ligesom slå op dit telt.
Campere.
Jeg camperer i håbet.
But move into faith.
Men bevæg dig og flytter ind i troen.
Let the word of God create faith in you.
Lad Guds ord få lov til at skabe tro i dig.
So you by faith can see yourself having it.
Så at du ved tro kan se dig selv have det.
So you do not walk by what you see, but you walk by what you believe.
Så du ikke går ved det du ser, men det du tror.
My friend, I have been challenged so many times in my life.
Min ven, jeg er blevet udfordret så mange gange i mit liv.
And I am not trying to say that I am perfect or I handle myself always in an advisable way.
Og jeg prøver ikke at sige, at jeg altid opfører mig perfekt og at jeg altid handler på en god og den måde jeg skulle.
Living this life.
Når jeg nu lever det her liv.
I have also done mistakes.
Har jeg også begået fejl.
And people are also have reasons to say, you know, that patience, he is this and that.
Og mennesker har sikkert også årsager til at sige, patience er sådan og sådan.
But you see, your life is not your mistakes.
Men dit liv er ikke dine fejltagelser.
Your life is in Christ.
Dit liv er i Kristus.
And his blood has cleansed you.
Og hans blod har renset dig.
So don't let your past kill your future.
Så lad ikke din fortid fortid dræbe din
fremtid. Don't let anybody define you, and we know who you are.
Lad ikke nogen få lov til at definere dig og sige, vi ved hvem du er.
We know where you come from.
Vi ved hvor du kommer fra.
And you will never become.
Og du kommer aldrig til at blive.
Maybe that was the truth if you remained the same.
Måske er det sandheden, hvis du forblev den samme.
But the grace of God lifts you up.
Men Guds nåde løfter dig op.
The Bible says if the righteous follow 7 times, he will stand.
Bibelen siger, at om det retfærdige falder 7 gange, så rejser Herren ham op igen.
The Lord will raise him up.
Herren vil rejse ham op.
So when I look at my life.
Så når jeg kigger på mit liv.
I have been in moments.
Jeg har været i øjeblikke,
where it was so hopeless that I can't even explain to you what hopeless was.
Hvor det var så håbløst, så jeg kan ikke engang forklare, hvor håbløst det var.
It was beyond my ability.
Det var ud over min evne.
But for some glorious reason.
Men af en eller anden herlig årsag.
The word of God spoken to me by God.
Så det Guds ord, som var talt til mig igennem Gud.
It was stronger than my hopeless circumstances.
Var stærkere end min håbløse omstændigheder.
It was stronger than my impossible reasons.
Det var stærkere end mine umulige årsager.
And it created faith in me.
Og det skabte en tro i mig.
That I knew, that I knew, that I knew.
At jeg vidste, at jeg vidste, at
that
jeg vidste.
By the grace of God.
At ved Guds nåde.
I will come through this painful this painful season victorious.
Så vidste jeg, at jeg kom igennem den her smertefulde sæson i sejr.
I knew that Jesus would glorify himself by a miracle.
Jeg vidste, at Jesus ville herliggøre sig selv igennem et mirakel.
Oh, then some clever person said to me one day.
Og så var der nogen klog person, som sagde til mig en dag.
They say, okay, Pastor Jens, nobody can argue you had all these marvelous miracles.
Der er jo ingen, der kan argumentere med dig, at du fik de her fantastiske mirakler.
But I prefer to live a steady life.
Men jeg foretrækker at leve et stille og stabilt liv.
By where there is not all these risks.
For der ikke er alle de her risikoer.
Good for you.
Rigtig godt for dig.
God bless you.
Gud velsigne dig.
Please continue to live
your steady life. Fortsæt at leve dit stille og dit stabile liv.
But some of us.
Men nogle af os.
We have seen the invisible.
Vi har set det usynlige.
We have seen that this is not our end station.
Vi har set, at det her ikke er endestationen.
Some of us have seen revival with our eyes of faith.
Nogle af os har set vækkelse med vores tros øjne.
We have seen the invisible.
Vi har set det usynlige.
And it is more real to us than what you can show us in the visible world.
Og det er mere virkeligt for os end det vi kan se i den synlige verden.
That's why we are not calmed down.
Det er derfor vi ikke er stille og rolige.
That's why we are shouting and pushing.
Det er derfor vi råber og presser på.
Because we have seen what God wants to give us.
Fordi vi har set det Gud vil give os.
And by faith we have received it.
Og ved troen har vi taget imod det.
And we are moving into the full manifestation.
Og vi bevæger os ind i den fulde manifestation af det.
So it says about Abraham's faith.
Så det står om Abrahams tro her.
Being fully convinced, verse 21.
Vers 21.
Being fully convinced.
Og fuldt overbevist.
That he who has promised also is able to perform.
At det som Gud har lovet, har han også magt til at udføre.
How can you believe in something which is hopeless?
Hvordan kan du tro på noget som er håbløst?
No. You don't believe in hopeless.
Nej, du tror ikke på det som er håbløst.
You can have hopeless circumstances.
Du kan have håbløse omstændigheder.
But you believe in a God.
Men du tror på en Gud.
That will fulfill his promise.
Som vil opfylde sine løfter.
I stood one day in a meeting.
Jeg stod en dag i et møde.
And as I was preaching.
Og imens jeg prædikede.
A woman came up to me.
Så var der en kvinde, der kom frem til mig.
And she had wrapped clothes in her arms.
Og hun havde nogle klæder i sin arme.
And she walked straight up to me in the midst of my message.
Og hun gik lige frem til mig midt i mit budskab.
And put these pieces of cloth in my
hand. Og lagde de her tøjstykker i min hånd.
And I said, "Woman, what is that?"
Og jeg sagde, min kvinde, hvad er det her?
She says, "It's my dead child."
Hun sagde, det er mit døde barn.
I said, "What?"
Jeg sagde, hvad?
I looked at it.
Jeg kiggede på det.
I had some other preachers looking.
Der var nogle andre prædikanter, som også kiggede.
There was medical people in the service who also came and looked.
Der var nogle læger, andre medicinske personer,
nurses and people
sygeplejersker.
And the child was dead.
Og barnet var dødt.
Now that is hopeless.
Det er jo håbløst.
I said, how long has it been dead?
Og jeg sagde, hvor lang tid har det været dødt?
And the mother said, for 3 days.
Og moren sagde, i 3 dage.
I asked her, why didn't you bury your child?
Og jeg spurgte hende, hvorfor begravede du ikke barnet?
She said, no, I saw how God used you to do a miracle of raising a dead in this city.
Og så sagde hun, nej, jeg så, hvordan Gud brugte dig til at opvække en død i den by.
And when I saw you advertised,
og da jeg så, at du blev annonceret,
I knew I have to go to the service and ask you to raise my child.
Så vidste jeg, at jeg var nødt til at gå til det her gudstjeneste og bede dig om at opvække mit barn.
I cannot say that it is me who had that great faith.
Jeg kan ikke sige, at det var mig, som havde den store tro.
I honestly believe, Pastelina, that it was the faith in that mother.
Jeg tror ærligt talt, at det var troen hos den mor.
I understand what Jesus said again and again when he said to these people, your faith has healed you.
Jeg forstår, hvad Jesus siger igen og igen til de her mennesker. Din tro har helbredt dig.
So I'm holding this child.
Så jeg holder det her barn.
And let me give you some behind stage information.
Og lad mig give dig noget bag scenen oplysninger.
I didn't just go ahead and say in the name of Jesus.
Jeg gik bare ikke bare sådan i gang med at sige i Jesu navn.
No, I asked. Nobody heard me say.
Ingen hørte mig sige det her.
But in my spirit.
Men i min ånd.
I said, Jesus, are you allowing me to raise this dead one?
Jesus, tillader du mig at opvække det her barn?
And if he would not have allowed me.
Og hvis han ikke havde tilladt mig.
Then I would not have dared doing it.
Så ville jeg ikke have turet at gøre det.
But when he spoke to me, I knew.
Men når han talte til mig, så vidste jeg.
I got peace in my spirit.
Jeg fik fred i min ånd.
And I knew.
Og så vidste jeg.
Beyond any doubt.
Udover alt tvivl.
That God will honor this woman's faith.
At Gud vil ære den her kvindes tro.
So I had this dead child in my.
Så jeg havde det her døde barn i mine hænder.
And I said in the name of Jesus.
Og jeg sagde i Jesu navn. I Jesu Kristi navn.
I command life to come back into this child.
Så befaler jeg livet at komme tilbage ind i dette barn.
My beloved friend.
Min elskede ven.
In the midst of this hopeless situation.
Midt i den her håbløse situation.
Suddenly the body shook.
Lige pludselig begyndte lemmet at røre sig.
And the child cried.
Og barnet skreg.
Have you ever been in a place where there is given birth to a child?
Har du nogensinde været på et sted hvor et barn bliver født?
The moment it comes out, it screams.
I det øjeblik det kommer ud, så begynder det at skrige.
That was how loud this child screamed.
Og det var så højt som det her barn skreg.
And the nurses there, they were running up to me.
Og sygeplejerskerne løb frem til mig.
And they took the child.
Og de tog barnet.
And they start, you know, working with it.
Og begyndte at arbejde med det.
Now what is my message to you?
Hvad er mit budskab til dig?
Maybe your challenge is not having a dead child in your arms.
Måske er ikke din udfordring, at du har et dødt barn i dine arme.
Maybe your challenge is finances.
Måske er din udfordring økonomi.
Maybe your challenge is your health.
Måske er din udfordring din helse.
Maybe your challenge is in your marriage.
Måske er din udfordring i din dit ægteskab.
Maybe your challenge is some circumstances.
Eller måske er din udfordring i nogle omstændigheder
Maybe
omkring dig.
Maybe your challenge is in your work.
Måske er din udfordring på dit arbejde.
There can be many difficult circumstances.
Der kan være mange, mange forskellige omstændigheder.
But let me testify.
Men lad mig vidne.
That when faith gets activated.
At når troen bliver aktiveret.
Then what Jesus said becomes the truth.
Så bliver det som Jesus sagde sandheden.
What did he say?
Hvad sagde han?
All things are possible for he who believes.
Alt er muligt for den som tror.
He said all things are possible for he who believes.
Han sagde alt er muligt for den som tror.
I want to encourage you as we are winding up this message.
Jeg vil gerne opmuntre dig, når vi nu afslutter det her budskab.
Not to continue just to have the confession of your hope.
Ikke at bare fortsætte at have din håbets bekendelse.
Let us not have a fellow common ground which are as low as possible.
Lad os ikke have en fælles grund eller niveau som bare er så lavt som muligt.
As little faith as possible.
Lad os få så lidt tro som muligt.
Let us not continue to preach that maybe God heals and maybe he doesn't.
Lad os ikke fortsætte med at forkynde, at måske helbreder Gud, måske gør han ikke.
Maybe he saves, maybe he doesn't.
Måske frelser han, måske ikke.
Maybe he loves you, maybe he doesn't.
Måske elsker han dig, måske elsker han dig ikke.
No.
Nej.
Let us be strong in our trust in God.
Lad os være stærk i vores tillid til Gud.
That he is a loving father.
At han er en kærlig far.
That he is a God that heals you.
Han er en Gud som helbreder dig.
He is the God of miracles.
Han er miraklernes Gud.
Let us rise up and have strong faith.
Lad os rejse os op og have en stærk tro.
Let us declare war against doubt in our mind.
Lad os gå i krig mod tvivlen i vores sind og tanker.
Let us be strong in the word of God.
Lad os være stærke i Guds ord.
Let us speak until we believe.
Lad os tale indtil vi tror.
Let us honor the word of God.
Lad os ære Guds ord.
You see, when you speak the word of God by faith.
Du forstår, når du begynder at tale Guds ord igennem tro.
God honors his word in your mouth as it was himself saying it.
Så ærer Gud sit ord i din mund, som om at det var ham selv der sagde det.
Did you get that?
Fik du fat i det?
When you speak by faith.
Når du taler i tro.
The word of God.
Guds ord.
Then God honors his word in your mouth.
Så ærer Gud sit ord i din mund.
As he himself said it.
Som om at det var ham selv der sagde.
That's why Jesus says whosoever says to this mountain.
Det er derfor Jesus siger at hvem som helst som siger til dette bjerg.
Be thou removed and cast into the sea.
Hæv dig op og kast dig i havet.
Pastor Lina, faith is never quiet.
Pastor Lina, tro er aldrig stille.
Faith is noisy.
Troen er larmende.
It speaks.
Den taler.
It overcomes doubt by its voice.
Den overvinder tvivlen ved sin stemme.
Whosoever says.
Hvem som helst som siger.
Now, what does the Bible say that Abraham knew God as?
Hvad siger Bibelen at Abraham kendte Gud som?
The God who calls upon things which are not as they are.
Den Gud som kalder på ting som ikke er som om de var.
If God can speak it into existence.
Hvis Gud kan tale det til eksistens.
Then we can speak his word into existence too.
Så kan vi også tale hans ord ind til eksistens.
It is God that perform his word.
Det er Gud som udfører sit ord.
But it is our faith that receives that miracle into our physical lives.
Men det er vores tro som tager det ind i vores fysiske liv. Igennem troen.
What does the Bible say?
Hvad er det Bibelen siger?
It says faith overcomes the world.
Det står at troen overvinder verden.
What does it mean?
Hvad betyder det?
It means every impossible thing in your world will be overcome by faith.
Det betyder at enhver umulig ting i din verden vil blive overvundet af troen.
So I want to encourage you.
Så jeg vil gerne opmuntre dig.
To let your faith grow stronger.
At lade din tro vokse sig stærkere.
To have God's word in your mind day and night.
At have Guds ord i din sind og dine tanker dag og nat.
Speak it to yourself.
Tal det til dig selv.
Think about it.
Tænk over det.
Pray about it.
Be over det.
Talk with your family
Tal
about it.
Tal med din familie om det.
Let it be in your mouth.
Lad det være i din mund.
Let it be in your mouth.
Lad det være i din mund.
And in your heart.
Og i dit hjerte.
The word of faith.
Troens ord.
Not the word of doubt.
Ikke tvivlens ord.
The word of faith.
Men troens ord.
Pastor Lena and Danis, I would say it like this. Let us be smik, smak, smask, fulde af tro.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. That's what we would say in Danish.
Let us be smik, smak, smask, full of faith.
Amen.
So how do we do that?
Så hvordan gør vi det?
It is not us doing it.
Det er ikke os, der gør det.
It is God's word in us that create that ability.
Det er Guds ord i os, som skaber den evne.
If you are weak in faith.
Hvis du er svag i troen.
Or if you are more in hope.
Eller hvis du er mere i håb.
You are not a mistake.
Så er du ikke en fejltagelse.
Nederlag.
Eller du har defeat.
You're not a defeat.
Du er ikke et nederlag.
You're just in hope.
Du er bare i håb.
That is divine.
Det er guddommeligt.
You are on your way to your miracle.
Du er på vej til dit mirakel.
And Hebrews says, hold on to the declaration, to the confession of hope.
Så Bibelen siger, hold fast ved bekendelsen af håbet.
Hebrews 10.
Hebræerbrevet 10.
Why does the Bible say that?
Hvorfor siger Bibelen det?
Because faith cometh by hearing.
Fordi tro kommer jo af
when
det der
you
høres.
Hear yourself declaring your hope.
Når du hører dig selv udtale og proklamere håbet.
It will transform hope to faith.
Så vil det forvandle troen eller håbet til tro.
And when you have faith.
Og når du har tro.
Then all things are possible.
Så er alt muligt.
My beloved friend.
Min elskede ven.
Let us believe in God.
Lad os tro på Gud.
Let us believe in his word.
Lad os tro på hans ord.
And let us trust that the Holy Spirit will help us to be strong in faith.
Så lad os have den tillid og at han vil hjælpe os til at blive stærke i ordet.
Amen.
Amen.
Father, in this moment I thank you for your word.
Far, i det her øjeblikket så vil jeg bare takke dig for dit ord.
And I pray that all doubt and fear shall be far away from you.
Og jeg beder at al frygt og tvivl skal være langt borte fra dig.
In the name of Jesus, I release the spirit of faith upon you.
I Jesu navn så forløser jeg troens ånd over
dig. I declare that in the atmosphere of KBC is a spirit of faith and unity.
Jeg proklamerer at i KBC så er der en atmosfære af tro og enhed.
An atmosphere of love and grace.
En atmosfære af kærlighed og nåde.
I declare in KBC there is an atmosphere of soul winning compassion.
Jeg proklamerer at i KBC er der en sjælevindende passion.
I declare that in KBC there is an atmosphere of miracles.
Jeg proklamerer at i KBC er der en atmosfære af mirakler.
There is an atmosphere of healing, signs and wonders.
En atmosfære af helbredelse, tegn og under.
I declare that in KBC there is a grace of financially breakthroughs.
Jeg proklamerer at i KBC er der noget til økonomisk gennembrud.
I declare that in KBC there is a capacity of seeing people being fulfilled in their God-given destiny.
Jeg proklamerer at i KBC er der en mulighed for at se mennesker blive kommet ind i fylden af sin bestemmelse.
That God himself will be glorified through what he is doing through us.
At Gud selv vil blive herliggjort gjort i det som han gør igennem os.
I declare in the name of Jesus.
Jeg proklamerer i Jesu navn.
That we are under the blood of Jesus.
At vi er under Jesu blod.
And nothing the devil is sending against us shall prosper.
Og intet af det som djævelen sender imod os skal du
he will
have.
Come maybe at one road.
Han kommer imod os på en vej.
But he will flee by seven.
Men han vil flygte af syv veje.
I declare that KBC is a blessing to Denmark.
Jeg proklamerer at KBC er en velsignelse for Danmark.
And Father, I declare.
Og far, vi proklamerer.
That every local church all over Denmark.
At enhver lokal kirke overalt i Danmark
is a blessing to their city.
Er en velsignelse for deres by.
And that they will glorify you too.
Og at de også vil herliggøre dig.
Father, thank you that doubt will come out of the body of Christ.
Far, tak at tvivlen kommer ud af Kristi legeme.
I come against the spirit of mediocrity.
Jeg kommer imod middelmådighedens ånd.
In Danish we have an expression saying snus fornuftig. That is, you know, you're just too much into your senses. And I come against that spirit.
Jeg kommer imod den ånd af snusfornuft.
That you are not doing anything risky.
At du ikke tager nogen risikoer.
That you are just standing there in the boat and seeing Peter stepping out on the water.
At du bare står der inde i båden, når du ser Peter gå ud på vandet.
And you judge him as he walk.
Og så dømmer du ham i det, han går.
I break that judgmental spirit.
Jeg bryder den der dømmende ånd.
I come against the spirit of envy in the body of Christ.
Jeg kommer imod misundelsens ånd i Kristi legeme.
Reverse it and speak unity.
Og jeg vender det og jeg taler enhed.
I speak, Father, a desire to win souls.
Jeg taler ud en længsel efter at vinde sjæle.
Let this be the greatest moment for the body of Christ.
Lad det her være det mest fantastiske øjeblik for Kristi legeme.
Let thousands of souls be harvested.
Lad tusindvis af sjæle blive indhøstet.
And let faith rise up in us.
Og lad troen rejse sig op i os.
So we can live to your glorification.
Så at vi kan leve til din herliggørelse.
Because you said that you are glorified as we bear much fruit.
Fordi du siger at vi bliver herliggjort igennem at vi bærer meget frugt.
In the name of Jesus.
I Jesu navn.
So my beloved friend, have a wonderful, wonderful Thursday evening.
Ha' en vidunderlig torsdag aften.
Maybe you're looking at this program later than Thursday, Friday, maybe Saturday. No matter when you look at it, be blessed.
Måske kigger du på det her på et senere tidspunkt, fredag eller nogen anden dag. Vær velsignet.
We declare that the blessings of God is on you.
Vi proklamerer at Herrens velsignelse er over dig.
And you will bear more fruit.
Og du skal bære meget mere frugt.
You will be more bold.
Og du skal være mere frimodig.
And you will be full of faith.
Og du skal være fyldt af tro.
In the name of Jesus.
I Jesu navn.
Amen.
Amen.